Freddy Kitchens, you are becoming a problem. You are becoming a problem. Your play calling is fucking horrible. You're getting Baker Mayfield fucking bludgeoned. You're getting him beat up. Your play calling, ever since last year, the last three, remember I said last three plays we had called against the Ravens when Mayfield dropped back and just started throwing the ball over the middle? The last three play calls were fucking horrible. I've never seen, I was like, that's the worst play calling I've ever seen. Well, it was until now. Your play calling all year has been substandard at best. You are a problem, and a problem that needs to be rectified. This is unacceptable. You got Baker Mayfield, a superstar, and it looks like he's regressing because your offensive line can't protect him. You can't get the ball out of his hands quick enough. Your play calling, you just can't stop yourself from taking deep shots. You got fucking Nicholas GX Chubb, a battering ram, and you only use him about three times, three-tenths of a game. It's like you don't want to use him! What the fuck? It's not like... You look at Baker Mayfield. He didn't play good the first week. He didn't play good the second week. But last night, he didn't play good, but he didn't play as bad as people think. I'm going to tell you something. The last throw he made was one of the best throws you'll see from an NFL quarterback. And you're like, he got intercepted. If that was Odell Beckham Jr. or Jarvis Landry, that's a touchdown. We go into overtime. Because you got to fight for that ball. Even Willie said that. That was a perfect throw on the run off his back foot. He threw a fucking bullet in there that Willie should have caught. No excuses. That was a great throw. And then he made a throw to the tight end prior to that, like two plays before that. Bounced right off his hands. It was a for sure touchdown. But on that same play, Jarvis Landry was wide open at the pylon. He missed him. But he did make a perfect throw to the tight end. It's not like he's out there holding the ball and people are wide open. He don't see him. No. People aren't getting open. They were doubling Beckham, and they were fucking shadowing Landry. So you basically, you got to understand something. We're without Odell. We're without Antonio Callaway, Hollywood Higgins, and David Njoku, three solidified starters. Name another team. We're playing without starters. You're like, oh, we got Odell. They got Landry. Yeah, they're being covered. All right? So we're without three starters on offense. Mayfield didn't play good, but he didn't play as bad as people are insisting. And I'm going to tell you another thing, too. Tom Brady, in his second year, lost four straight games. I read an article on this yesterday. He played like dog shit in them four straight games. Quarterbacks struggle in their second year. But Mayfield was under duress the whole night. You cannot, if you know football, look at Mayfield and say he's the problem. The problem is the offensive line and Freddie Kitchens' fucking horrible play calling. That's the fucking problem. His play calling is fucking horrible. I want to take my hat off to Steve Wilks. The whole secondary was missing because they're injured, and he came up with a game plan that shut down the vaunted Rams offense. We allowed the Rams to score 20 points. You allow the Rams to score 20 points, you should win that game. But Freddie Kitchens didn't do... Oh, wait a second. Freddie Kitchens, I forgot. Fourth and nine, he does a fucking... Freddie Kitchens tries a draw. It's like he was watching Marty Schottenheimer when he handed the ball off to Ernest Byner. I think it was 4th and 19 or 4th and 20. Ernest Byner fucking ran a touchdown in for the Browns, and they won the game against the Redskins. Anyone remember that? It's almost like he went back to that play. That was the stupidest play call I ever fucking seen, you fucking jackass. Dumbest play call ever! Dumbest! Not to mention Mayfield. We get a turnover, and Mayfield fucking fumbles the handoff. But yeah, Mayfield ain't the reason. It's the offensive line and Freddie Kitchens. But I want to take a hat off to Steve Wilks. Undermined. He went out there and he fucking had his defense perform great. They shut down the Rams and they did good. The Browns defense is no joke. Minus the whole secondary, the whole starting secondary. And that defense for the Rams, they held the Saints to 9 points the week before. So they're no joking. Aaron Donald's a fucking stud. So no one should put this loss on Mayfield. Hey, he's not playing good. I'll be the first to tell you that. He's regressed. But there's a reason why he's under constant duress. Last night was a picture-perfect way of looking at a second-year quarterback just being badgered. He had no chance. Everybody's ready to write Mayfield the Browns out. Let me remind you something. We play the Baltimore Ravens next Sunday at Baltimore. Do you realize if the Cleveland Browns win that game, they are in first place? Do you realize that? Yes, the sky is not falling, people. We win Sunday, we're in first fucking place. That's how fucking bad the sky's falling, you jackasses. This team will get this shit figured out. The offense will. The defense is fine. The offense will get it figured out. They will get it figured out. Trust me. I knew it was going to take time. It was going to take time for all these players to mess. Plus, we're without three starters. Hollywood, Higgins, Callaway, and Njoku are big parts of this offense. You see Jarvis Landry and Beckham playing. You're like, oh, they got it. No. We're without three solid starters. Wait till we get healthy before you judge us. But like I say, we're all right. We win Sunday, we're in first place. Take that to the fucking bank. The defense, I'm sure Steven Wilkes will have something going for Lamar Jackson. So in closing, the sky isn't falling. Freddie Kitchens is a fucking jackass joke. He's horrible. I'm very disappointed in Frederick Kitchens, and we're fine. We're in good shape. The Browns will beat Baltimore. And in case closed, we're fine. I don't know why Browns fans are so fucking, they're like nervous. We're fine. You guys need to understand, we're fine. We're all right. Get it through your fucking heads. We're fine.